حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة، آت محمدا الوسيلة والفضيلة، وبعثه مقاما محمودا الذي وعدته، إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى أصحابه والتابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. أما بعد, respected gathering, we begin by praising and thanking Allah سبحانه وتعالى for having brought us here today, having gathered us here today in the house of Allah, the greatest place in this world on earth. And on this Friday, the Eid of the week for Muslims, and for this occasion of Salatul Jumu'ah, a great, great occasion. And those of us who have come early, we thank Allah for giving us the tawfiq to come early and to having for choosing us above other people to come here and gain more reward than those people who will come after. Whoever comes first on the day of Jumu'ah, he gains the most reward. Even if there's a million people, then whoever came first, he will have the most reward, and then the person after. That is one of the sunnah and adab, etiquette of Jumu'ah, they come early. Last week we heard a brief account of the Seerah. The Seerah is the life. The life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is known as the Seerah, Seeratul Nabi. We heard a brief account of his life, and we also were told that in order to follow him, you have to know about him. If you don't know about somebody, you cannot follow him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is one of these, the greatest blessing that Allah has given to mankind. Not only this ummah, but even the people before him. On the day of judgment, the whole of mankind, people of Nuh alayhi salam, of Adam alayhi salam, they will go to Adam, they will go to Nuh, they will go to Ibrahim, and they will say, do sufarish, ask Allah to forgive us, ask Allah to forgive us. They will say, we did wrong. Adam will say that I ate from that tree, don't come to me. I ate from, Nuh alayhi salam will say, I told Allah to forgive my son when he was a non-Muslim. Ibrahim will say, I said something which wasn't true, and so on. And even the ummah of Adam alayhi salam, they will depend, they will rely on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. They will, the ummah of Nuh alayhi salam, they will go to Muhammad for forgiveness. He is a blessing for not only this ummah, but the whole of mankind, from Adam alayhi salam to the last person that will come to this world. And because of this, we have become, because of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he is the greatest prophet, and because of him being our prophet, we are the greatest ummah. Greatest Ummah, Allah has mentioned this clearly, كنتم خير أمة. You are the greatest nation that Allah has sent to the world. So because of our Prophet, we have become the greatest nation. And because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is our Prophet, we have a better chance. Through our Prophet, we have a better chance than the people before us to enter Jannah. Through our Prophet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah wants everybody to go to Jannah. Allah does not want to punish anybody. He will not gain anything. He will not become more powerful by punishing anybody. He wants to send everybody to Jannah. And because of this, He has told us the way to enter Jannah. And one of these ways is our Prophet. Allah, because He wants us to enter Jannah, He has shown us the best way. And He has said that if you do these three things, if you follow the Prophet, if you follow him, if you listen to him, and if you love him, then you will go to Jannah. And because this is something which will benefit us, Allah has made it for us compulsory, so that we do it. Because if you did not make it compulsory, we being weak human beings, He would say, it's not compulsory, and we wouldn't do it, and we would lose out. Therefore, to make it easy for everybody to enter Jannah, Allah has made a few things compulsory for our benefit. And regarding our Prophet, He has made three things compulsory. He has made following him compulsory. He has made listening to him, his orders, compulsory. And He has made loving him compulsory. And He has made this clear in the verses in the Holy Quran. Allah says in a well-known verse, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ, that tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ, if you want to love Allah, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ, if you want to love Allah, then what should you do? Tell the people, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, follow me. Follow me. If you follow me, what will happen? يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ, Allah will love you. يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرَ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ, Allah will do your maghfirat, He will forgive your sins. يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. So, if you want to love Allah, if you want to love Allah, which we have to do, then the way is to follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Further on, Allah says, قُلْ أَطِيعُ اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ, that tell them, O Muhammad, listen, ita'at, mean listen, أَطِيعُ اللَّهِ and وَالرَّسُولِ, follow Allah, do Allah ita'at and do the ita'at, follow the Prophet. This is the way, so to love, to follow the Prophet is something we have to do. And to listen to him, ita'at, to listen to him is something we have to do. And the last thing, to love him. In a hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, لا يؤمن أحدكم, none of you can be a complete believer until I, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, am more beloved to you than your children, than your parents, and the whole of mankind. Until I am more beloved to you more than your children, then you cannot become a true believer. Therefore, to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is something we have to do. To follow him and to listen to him are things we have to do in order to become successful in this world and enter Jannah. Now moving on quickly, if any of us here, those of us who are here, any Muslim, if somebody was to ask you and I, who do you love the most? The answer that we will give, or the answer that we can give, is that we will say we love Muhammad. Who do you love the most? If I ask, and if anybody asks us, who do you love the most? We will say straight away, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is the answer we will give, and the only answer we can give. However, this answer, let's look at this answer that we are giving. When somebody asks us, do you love Allah, do you love the Prophet, we say, of course we do. He is the most beloved. I love him more than my children, more than my parents more than everybody. I love him more than anyone. We will say that. But let's look at this answer. How much truth is there? If we look at this answer, then the only conclusion or result that we get from this answer by looking at the answer is that those of most people who give this answer, not everybody, but a lot of people who give this answer are just not telling the truth. They are lying. They are plainly lying. Why are they lying? Why is this a lie? If you look, an example, in this world, when we say we love somebody, what do we mean? In this world, there are, in this day and age, there are many people who we look up to, or Muslims look up to, people look up to, TV, people on the screen stars, then sports stars, people, we look up to them because they have a high position, they are very famous. And a lot of people, many Muslims, they begin to idolize, they begin to like these people a lot. And in these cases, we see an example of true love, what loving somebody more than anyone does. For example, somebody may love a certain footballer and he will be mad about him. Even Muslims, there will be many Muslims who will idolize certain sports stars. It doesn't have to be football stars, but anyone, any sports stars, they idolize them. And we see that they tend to follow them as much as possible. They try to be like them in the way they keep their hair, in the way they keep their beard, in the way they dress, in the car they buy, in the food they like, in the way they dress, in the way they walk. They try to follow them in every, because they like them. And they learn about these people. They learn about his history, his family's name, his children's name. And if you ask them, tell me about this person, they will tell you, oh, he was born here, he was born there, he went to this school, and then he got this many GCSEs, then he went there, and so on. His hobbies are this, his favorite food is pasta or something. They will tell you everything that you'd want to know about this person, because they love him. This is the example of somebody loving somebody. So this answer that we will give, or Muslims give, that we love Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than anyone. Let's study this answer, and then let's look at Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the person that we claim to love more than anyone. And let's first of all look at the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let's look at his life and how he lived, how he dressed, how he ate, how he acted with his wife, how he was with people. Let's look at his life, and then let's look at ourselves. Let's look at ourselves and see, we claim, we say, we all say that we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we love him, let's see what example is there to show that we love him. Let's look at ourselves. Let's look at how we look. Look at our faces. Look at the way we dress. Look at our children. Look at our houses, look at our marriages, look at our work life, our social life, look at the inside of our houses, everything. Look at our lives and then ask yourself, is there, we claim to love Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is there any sign of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Is there any sign of the seerah, of the sunnah in our lives? And the answer that we will get from this second question is that sadly, there isn't. Many people, you don't see a sign of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in anything that they do. This is the sad reality. So this, the answer, when I meant that many people will be lying, is this is the truth. They will be lying. If you claim to love somebody, we should see that. In the world, we see somebody loving, we see that this person, we can tell that this person, he's copying him. We can tell by his looks. This person is copying him. Because we know how this famous person is. We know that now I know he's copying him. He has the same hairstyle, he's copying him. So if somebody looks at you, can they say that, oh, this person, he's copying Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? See, if people can't look at you and see any sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on you, then the truth is that you are not loving the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the way that you should be. Therefore, when we, of course, if somebody does ask you and I, who do you love, we have to give this answer. But we should try to make sure that this answer is the true answer. Is a true answer. We can't just say this answer at the same time. We can't at the same time that every sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we seem to oppose. And we give this answer, and at the same time, we give preference to the ways, to the examples of the non-Muslims, the enemies of the Islam, the enemies of the Prophet himself. We give preference to their ways. We choose their ways over the way and over the model of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah has told us that the best example, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. In the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you have the best example to follow. If you are thinking, what shall I wear? How shall I dress? The example is there of how to dress. If you're looking, I'm going for a haircut today. What hairstyle should I choose? The example is there. You don't look at the posters on the wall of the barber shop and think, let me choose him. No. As a Muslim, your only role model is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is no other perfect human, perfect person in this world that you can follow. If there was, then maybe you could follow, but there isn't anyone. Even the people that we seem to think are educated and intelligent. This week, the truth came out as to how these people are. In this week, there was a bill in the House of Commons where there was a vote to legalize same gender marriages, to legalize gay marriages. And we saw how clever these people were and how astray that they've gone. So if you look up at these people, these are not people to look up to. The only person that we can look up to, the only person that we can say is perfect and he has no wrongdoing, is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is the person to follow, and he is the person that we have to follow. And we have to follow so that we can become successful. If we follow him, then Allah says, if you want to love me, then follow the Prophet. If you follow the Prophet, you love me. If you love Allah, Allah loves you, then you will go to Jannah. And also, if you claim to love him, you have to learn about him. You have to learn about him. Many of us here were to be asked, okay, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tell me, you love him more than anyone. Tell me something. What's his full name, Muhammad? What's his full name? Tell me his name, the full name. Not many people can tell you. Tell me who his father was. Tell me his father's name. They can't tell you. Tell me his mother's name. They can't tell me. They can't tell you. Tell me where he was born. Even some people can't even tell you that. Tell me one of his daughter's names. They can't tell you. So if you love somebody, you have to learn about him. You can't say, I love him, but I don't know anything about him. In the same way that people, when they love somebody in the world, they know everything. Tell me about this football star. Where does he live? Or he lives in London. He lives in that street. What car has he got? He's got this car. What's his wife's name? They can tell you. What's his children's name? They can tell you. So if you love somebody, you have to learn about him. By learning about him, then you will have more love for that person. That's a sign that you love somebody, that you know about him. So moving on quickly, and because of this state that people, they have gone far away from the Prophet, this is the reason as to why we have, the Muslim Ummah has gone down in recent history. We have left his life, and because we've left his life, that's why the Muslim Ummah, the Muslims, we are suffering. Because we have no one to follow, we're not following the right example. And the non-Muslims, they have studied history. They have seen that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from nothing, at one time there was nothing in Arabia. From nothing, he created the biggest religion ever, and he took over so much land. He became successful because of his character, his way of life. And the non-Muslims, they have taken they have taken, they are following the Sunnah. Although they're not following the religion, they're following the Sunnah, his ways. And because of this, they have become successful. And we Muslims, we have left our own Prophet and we have disintegrated, we have become down. And the only way that we can come back is by following the Sunnah of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is the only way that we can, that we, our, the good days of Islam will return. There is no other way. This is the best example. If you want the good of this world, follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is no one else to follow. There is no one else to follow. If there is, then come and tell me that this person is worth following. There is nobody else in this world that you can't follow. Follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as much as you can, and this will be, you will see success in this world. Your life will become better, and in the hereafter, there will be the reward of Jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us, to put in our hearts the love for our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and give us the ability to follow him in the correct way. Follow him in the, also following the Prophet, you have to know how to follow him. Go to people and tell them, how do I do this? Don't follow him as you wish, or I read in this book, he did this. No, you have to learn from the scholars how to follow him in the correct way. If you follow him, if you love him, listen to him, this is the way. وَمَنْ يُتَعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ Allah says very clearly, whoever follows, listens to Allah and his Prophet, فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا They have indeed become very, very successful. This is a very clear, it's a very clear sentence that if you follow Allah, if you follow the Prophet, you will become successful both in this world and in the hereafter. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us all the ability to follow the Prophet, to listen to him and to love him in the way that Allah wants us to do. Quick announcement regarding the parking. A few issues regarding the parking. First of all, one problem that we have is people reversing out of the car park. Okay, this is something which please try not to reverse. Why should you not reverse? It's very, if you use your common sense, you will know. It's, we're positioned in a very awkward place, in a junction, in a corner, with traffic coming around the bend. Reversing out, it causes, if the car coming with speed around the bend, it can easily be an accident. So please do not reverse out. And also, if you have to reverse out, let's say you have to, don't reverse out, but let's say you have to, then even then Allah has given everybody a brain, use your common sense. There's two ways of reverse. You can reverse right, you can reverse left. Think to yourself, which way will cause less problems? If you reverse left, then you're only blocking traffic one way and you can quickly go. If you try to reverse right and go this way, then you're blocking traffic both this way and this way. And then what happens, the cars waiting to go, cars horning, people looking around, and then people swearing, looking at the masjid, and it causes a scene. So try not to reverse at all. And another thing, when you come into the car park, if the car park is free, once again, use your common sense. Quickly turn your car so that when you're going out, it's easy for you to go out. Many times I see people, they come in and the whole car park is empty and they position the car facing the wall. And then when they're going out, they have to reverse out or they have problems. So when you come in and the car park is empty, or even if it's not empty, try to position your car so when you're going out, you don't have to reverse. And also, under no circumstance, reverse your car out. Even if you're the last person near the entrance and you have no space to reverse, then wait in your car. Wait till other people have gone out and then reverse your car in the car park. If you don't have time to wait, then please don't park inside the car park. Park on the road where you don't have to wait for anybody. Please try to do this, otherwise someday something's going to happen and everybody will look, the people, they look at the masjid authorities, they will come to ask, why are your people doing this? So from now on, please try, don't reverse out. As much, if you have to, then you have to. Doesn't mean that if you have to, then you just keep your car here and go home walking. No, if you have to, you have to. If you have to, at least reverse to the left so you're not causing as much inconvenience. I hope everybody understands and please try to act upon this advice from now on. جزاكم الله خير واخر دعوايا الحمد لله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إيمانا به وتوحيدا وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله أيده بالمعجزات الباهرة والآيات الظاهرة فصلى الله وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أما بعد فاتقوا الله عباد الله تفوزوا وتفلحوا واتبعوا سنة نبيكم صلى الله عليه وسلم تسعدوا وتهتدوا أيها المسلمون اعلموا أن أعظم نعم الله عز وجل علينا أن جعل أفضل رسله نبينا وقائدنا لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين فأصبحنا لأجلها خير الأمم كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر وفي هذه النعمة العظمى الجليلة الفريدة فلاحنا وسعادتنا في دنيانا وما يتلوها وربنا الرؤوف الرحيم يريد بنا اليسر ويريد لنا الفلاح والنجاح فلاغتنامنا هذه النعمة الكبرى فرض علينا طاعة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وفرض علينا اتباعه ومحبته فقال عز وجل قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم. قل أطيعوا الله والرسول فإن تولوا فإن الله لا يحب الكافرين. وعن أنس رضي الله عنه قال: قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والدي وولدي والناس أجمعين. رواه البخاري في كتاب الإيمان. إخوة الإيمان، عندما يسأل مسلم كأنا وأنتم: من أحب الناس إليك؟ من أحب الناس إليك؟ فيجيب بدون أي فكرة: محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. كذاب ثم كذاب ثم كذاب أشر. وإن هذا الجواب لا روح فيه، لا روح فيه، بل هو ملآن بأفائك تلو الأفائك. لماذا؟ إننا نرى في زمننا هذا أن هناك من نجوم الشاشة أو من نجوم الرياضة من حبب إلى بعض المسلمين، فيحبه مسلم فلان حق الحب، ولم يأل جهدا باتباعه في كل شيء من السورة والأكل والشرب واللبس والمشي والكلام وتسمية الأبناء، حتى يحزن مما يحزن ويفرح مما يفرح، وكأنه هو ظلون. ثم ارجعوا أيها المسلمون إلى جوابنا، إلى جوابنا أن محمدًا صلى الله عليه وسلم أحب الناس إلينا، وافتحوا كتب السيرة والسنة ثم انظروا إلى أنفسنا، انظروا إلى صورنا وإلى وجوه شبابنا وملابس نسائنا وتربية أولادنا وداخل بيوتنا وحياتنا الاجتماعية والدينية وحياتنا كلها من ولادتنا إلى مماتنا. أين اتباعنا؟ أين اتباعنا لنبينا وطاعتنا ومحبتنا؟ هل ترون مثقال ذرة من السنة؟ هل ترون مثقال ذرة من السنة؟ أم أنتم من اللاعبين؟ فمن أحب إلينا الآن وهذا هو حالنا؟ أيها المسلمون، إذن كيف ندعي حب من لا نترك سنة من سنن إلا نخالفها؟ وأن لنا ادعاؤنا هذا، ونؤثر على أسوة نبينا الحسنة أسوة الكفرة والمشركين أعداء الدين، أعداء نبينا وأعداء ربنا. وكيف ندعي اتباع نبينا عليه الصلاة والسلام ولا نعرف عنه إلا اسمه بل نصف اسمه؟ قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يكون هوى تبعا لما جئت به. قال النووي: حديث حسن صحيح. إخوة الإيمان، لأجل كوننا في غفلة من السنة النبوية، نرى الأمة الإسلامية اليوم فيما نرى تفرقت شيعاً وأحزاباً، وتعددت المذاهب والروايات، وعمت الفتن والابتلاءات، وهلما جرى. أيها المسلمون، اسمعوا ما قال لكم ربكم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول ولا تولوا عنه وأنتم تسمعون. فإن تنازعتم في شيء فردوه إلى الله والرسول إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر ذلك خير وأحسن تأويلا. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن، ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من البيان. أقول ما تسمعون، وأستغفر الله الغفار الغفور لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي أمرنا باتباع ونهانا عن الابتداع، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تمسك بسنته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فاتقوا الله أيها المسلمون، واعلموا أن عز الأمة وسعادتها وصلاحها وهدايتها كل ذلك مرهون بتمسكها بكتاب ربها وسنة نبيها صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشواهد هذا جلية في نصوص الشرع وحوادث التاريخ. وإن حاجة الأمة إلى معرفة سيرة الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم والاقتباس من مشكات النبوة فوق كل حاجة. فكل من يرجو الله واليوم الآخر يجعل الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام قدوته وأسوته، كما قال عز وجل: لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. فهلموا معاشر المسلمين، هلموا إلى سنة نبيكم وسنة خلفائه الراشدين، وتمسكوا بها وعدوا عليها بالنواجذ، تفلحوا وتسعدوا في الأولى والآخرة. حب النبي على الأنام فريضة، لا تنس ذكر الهاشمي الأكرم. إن الصلاة على النبي وسيلة، فيها النجاة لكل عبد مسلم. صلوا على القمر المنير، فإنه نور تبدى في الغمام المظلم. رحم العباد به عزيز قادر، فالشكر لله العلي المنعم. ثم صلوا وسلموا رحمكم الله على خير البرية وأزكى البشرية جمعاء، نبينا وحبيبنا وسيدنا محمد. فقد أمركم الله تعالى بهذا في كتابه المبين قائلا وآمرا: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد إمام المرسلين وخاتم النبيين، ورضى اللهم عن أربعة الخلفاء الراشدين أولي الفضل الجلي والقدر علي أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، ورضى اللهم عن عمي نبيك حمزة والعباس، وعن السبطين السعيدين أبي محمد الحسن وأبي عبد الله الحسين، وعن أمهما فاطمة الزهراء، وعن زوجات نبيك الطاهرات أمهات المؤمنين، وعن الصحابة أجمعين والتابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر دينك وكتابك وسنة نبيك وعبادك الصالحين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين في كل مكان، اللهم ارحم إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان، اللهم ارحم إخواننا في سوريا، اللهم ارحم إخواننا في غزة، وارحم إخواننا المستضعفين أينما كانوا. اللهم عجل لهم بالنصر والفرج يا أرحم الراحمين، يا راحم المساكين، يا ناصر المستضعفين. انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان، وأنجذ وعدك، وكان حقا علينا نصر المؤمنين. اللهم اجعل جميع بلاد المسلمين آمنة مطمئنة محفوظة إلى يوم الدين. اللهم ول أمورنا خيارنا، وأبعد عنا شرارنا. اللهم ول أمورنا خيارنا، ولا تول أمورنا بذنوبنا شرارنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصرنا على القوم الكافرين، اللهم لا تجعل للكافرين على المؤمنين سبيلا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم عليك بالظلمة الخونة الكفرة في كل مكان. اللهم اشف صدورنا بهزيمتهم، اللهم أهلكهم كما أهلكت عادا وثمود، اللهم اشف صدورنا بهلاكهم أجمعين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم فرج هم المهمومين من المسلمين، ونفس كرب المكروبين، واقض الدين عن المدينين، واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين، واقض حاجاتنا وحاجات جميع المسلمين، وحاجات جميع الحاضرين، وحاجات جميع من أوصانا بالدعاء لهم يا قاضي الحاجات يا أرحم الراحمين.
اللهم رزقنا حبك، اللهم رزقنا حبك، اللهم رزقنا حب نبيك، اللهم رزقنا حب العمل الذي يقربنا إلى حبك وإلى حب نبيك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم رزقنا حب نبيك، اللهم وفقنا، اللهم وفقنا لاتباع نبينا على طريق يرضيك عنا يا كريم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم أحينا وأنت راض عنا وتوفنا يا رحمن الرحيم، وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا غير غضبان. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقيم الصلاة.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
استووا اعتدلوا. Straighten the rows, stand closely together, fill any gaps. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
والضحى والليل إذا سجى، ما ودعك ربك وما قلى، وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى، ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى، ووجدك ضالا فهدى، ووجدك عائلا فأغنى. فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر، وأما السائل فلا تنهر، وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله استغفر الله. اللهم انت السلام ومنك السلام تبارك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
Thank you. السلام عليكم. تقريبا